Kurunji Senior Secondary School, CBSE, Namakkal.
Successful, result-producing school in state every year.
Administered by the Board of Directors with over 35 years of experience in the teaching field.
Special attention on art, craft, music, dance, silambam, yoga, skating and karate.
Focus on Hindi Sabha and Spell Bee Olympiad exams.
Smart class for effective and innovative learning and well-furnished library.
Solitary importance on sports and games in state and national level.
WhatsApp facilities to know activities of students and school inside the campus.
NEET, JEE, IIT coaching experts from Rajasthan and Andhra Pradesh along with our effective teachers.
Admission registration for classes LKG to plus 2.
Kurunji Educational Institution, Kavetipatti, Namakkal. Admission in progress. CBSE, KG to 12, contact 9025895176. Metric 6 to 12, contact 9344567484. For online admission, log on to www.kurunjischoolnkl.in.
Hello students, we are discussing exercise 6.2, problems on increasing and decreasing functions. Question number 15, let I be any interval disjoint from minus 1 to plus 1. Prove that the function given by f of x equal to x plus 1 upon x is strictly increasing on I. What is given here? I be any interval disjoint from closed interval minus 1 to plus 1. Simply, I is a subset of R minus closed interval minus 1 to plus 1. Okay? R minus closed interval minus 1 to plus 1. Means I is any interval other than closed interval minus 1 to plus 1. Any interval other than closed interval minus 1 to plus 1. Okay? Now what we have to prove? We have to prove that the function f of x equal to x plus 1 upon x is strictly increasing on I. Strictly increasing on I. Okay? What is given function? Given function is f of x equal to x plus 1 by x. Now differentiate with respect to x. F dash of x is equal to x derivative 1 plus 1 by x derivative minus 1 by x square. F dash of x is equal to 1 minus 1 by x square. Take LCM, x square minus 1 by x square. F dash of x is equal to what? X square minus 1 by x square. So what is I? I is an interval disjoint from closed interval minus 1 comma plus 1. Means if you consider any element x belongs to I, it is other than closed interval minus 1 to plus 1. So what you can write, x is either less than minus 1 or x is either greater than plus 1. Okay, x is either less than minus 1 or x is greater than plus 1. Okay, now if x is less than minus 1 or x is greater than plus 1. Okay, now x square is always greater than 1. If you consider any number less than minus 1 or greater than plus 1, its square is always greater than 1. Okay, so if x less than minus 1 or x greater than plus 1, then x square minus 1 is always greater than 0. Because x square is always greater than 1, x square minus 1 is always greater than 0. So numerator is positive, denominator is also positive, x square, and x is either less than minus 1 or plus greater than plus 1. Obviously x square is greater than 1, so denominator is greater than 1, numerator is greater than 0, so overall ratio is what? Greater than 0. So f dash of x is greater than 0. Okay, as f dash of x is greater than 0, f of x is strictly increasing on I. F of x is strictly increasing on I. Okay, what is given here is I is any interval other than closed interval minus 1 to plus 1. Okay, disjoint from closed interval minus 1 to plus 1. Okay, prove that the function f of x equal to x plus 1 by x is strictly increasing on I. Okay, means any interval other than closed interval minus 1 to plus 1 means either x is less than minus 1 or x is greater than plus 1. Okay. Now, given function is f of x equal to x plus 1 by x, differentiate with respect to x, we get f dash of x is equal to x derivative 1 plus 1 by x derivative minus 1 by x square. Take LCM, x square minus 1 by x square. F dash of x is equal to x square minus 1 by x square. Okay. Now, as I is disjoint from minus 1 to plus 1, Okay, if you consider any element x belong to the set I, okay, then x is less than minus 1 or x is greater than plus 1. Okay, now in any case, either x less than minus 1 or x greater than plus 1, x square is always greater than 1. Now as x square is greater than 1, x square minus 1 is greater than 0. X square minus 1 is greater than 0 and denominator x square is greater than 1. So positive upon positive is positive only, no? So f dash of x is positive. Now as f dash of x is positive, f of x is strictly increasing on I. Okay? Next, question number 16. Prove that the function f of x equal to log sin x. F of x equal to log sin x is strictly increasing in 0 to pi by 2, strictly decreasing in pi by 2 to pi. Okay, f of x is equal to log of sin x is increasing in first quadrant, decreasing in second quadrant. Now, as f of x is equal to log of sin x, f dash of x is equal to what? Differentiating with respect to x on both sides, what we get? F dash of x is equal to log x derivative 1 by x, no? So, log of sin x derivative 1 by sin x, by chain rule sin x derivative is cos x. So, 1 by sin x into cos x. 1 by sin x into cos x. Now, 1 by sin x into cos x, nothing but cos by sin is cot x. So, f dash of x is equal to what? Cot x. F dash of x is cot x. F dash of x is cot x. But in the interval 0 to pi by 2, in the interval 0 to pi by 2, means in first quadrant all trigonometric ratios are positive. All trigonometric ratios are positive. So, cot x is also positive. Now, cot x positive means f dash of x is greater than 0. So, f dash of x is greater than 0. Okay. As f dash of x is greater than 0, f of x is increasing function. So, f of x is strictly increasing in 0 to pi by 2. So, first quadrant f of x equal to log sin x is strictly increasing function. Okay. Now, what is given here? F of x is equal to log of sin x. Okay. Differentiating with respect to x, what we get? Log of sin x derivative 1 by sin x derivative cos x. Nothing but cos by sin is cot x. F dash of x is equal to cot x. F dash of x is cot x. In first quadrant, all six trigonometric ratios are positive. So, cot x is also positive in first quadrant. So, cot x positive means f dash of x is positive. F dash of x is greater than 0. So, f of x is strictly increasing in 0 to pi by 2. Okay. Now, in pi by 2 to pi, in pi by 2 to pi, in second quadrant, which trigonometric ratios are positive? Sine and cosecant positive. Remaining four trigonometric ratios are negative. Means cot x is also negative. So, in second quadrant, cot x negative. Okay. In pi by 2 to pi, cot x is negative. So, cot x negative means f dash of x is negative. So, f dash of x is less than 0 in pi by 2 to pi. Now, as f dash of x is negative, f of x is a decreasing function. F of x is strictly decreasing in pi by 2 to pi. F of x is strictly decreasing in pi by 2 to pi. Okay. In second quadrant, in pi by 2 to pi, only sine and its reciprocal cosecant are positive trigonometric functions. Remaining four, tan, cot, cos and secant. These four are negative. So, cot x is negative. So, cot x negative means f dash of x is less than 0. As f dash of x is less than 0, f of x is strictly decreasing function on pi by 2 to pi. Okay? Next question. Prove that f of x equal to log of cos x is strictly decreasing in 0 to pi by 2 and strictly increasing on pi by 2 to pi. Similar to previous question, what you have to prove here? Function f of x equal to log of cos x is decreasing on 0 to pi by 2, decreasing on first quadrant, increasing on second quadrant. That is what we have to prove. Now, given function is log of cos x, now differentiate with respect to x. So, what we get? F of x derivative f dash of x is equal to log of cos x, log x derivative 1 by x, 1 by cos x, cos x derivative is minus sin x, okay, minus sin x. Okay, sin by cos is what? Tan, minus is there. So, f dash of x is equal to what? Minus tan x. F dash of x is equal to minus tan x. F dash of x is minus tan x. Now, in first quadrant, in 0 to pi by 2, in 0 to pi by 2, in first quadrant, all six trigonometric ratios are positive. So, sin positive, cos positive, tan positive, okay? And their reciprocals also positive. So, in 0 to pi by 2, tan x is greater than 0. in 0 to pi by 2, tan x is positive. Now, as tan x is positive, we multiply minus on both sides, minus tan x is negative. Minus tan x is negative. Now, minus tan x negative, minus tan x is nothing but f dash of x. Now, f dash of x is less than 0. Now, f dash of x is less than 0 means f is a strictly decreasing function. Okay, so f is strictly decreasing in 0 to pi by 2. F is strictly decreasing in 0 to pi by 2. Okay, second part. Now, another interval is what? Pi by 2 to pi. Now, in pi by 2 to pi, what we know in second quadrant, sine and cosecant positive, remaining four trigonometric ratios are negative. So, in second quadrant, in pi by 2 to pi, tan x is negative. Now, as tan x is less than 0, minus tan x is greater than 0. So, minus tan x is greater than 0. Okay, tan x is less than 0, minus tan x is greater than 0. So, minus tan x is greater than 0 means f dash of x is greater than 0. Okay, f dash of x is greater than 0. Now, f dash of x is greater than 0 means f of x is strictly increasing function. So, f is strictly increasing in pi by 2 to pi. F is strictly increasing function in pi by 2 to pi. Okay. Now, what is given here is, we have to prove that f of x is equal to log of cos x is strictly decreasing in first quadrant, strictly increasing in second quadrant. Okay. Now, f of x is equal to log x. F of x is equal to log of cos x, its derivative f dash of x is equal to log of cos x derivative 1 by cos x derivative minus sin x. Okay, minus sin by cos is minus tan x. F dash of x is equal to minus tan x. Okay. Now, in first quadrant, all six trigonometric ratios are positive. So, tan x is also positive. So, tan x positive, but minus tan x is negative. Multiplying minus on both sides. So, f dash of x is negative. So, f dash of x is negative in first quadrant means f of x is decreasing in first quadrant. F of x is strictly decreasing in 0 to pi by 2. Okay. In second quadrant, tan x is negative. Okay. Multiply with minus on both sides. Minus tan x is positive. Minus tan x positive means f dash of x is greater than 0. As f dash of x is greater than 0 in second quadrant, f is strictly increasing in second quadrant. F is strictly increasing in pi by 2 to pi. Okay. Next question. Prove that the function f given by f of x is equal to x cube minus 3x square plus 3x minus 100 is increasing in R. Prove that the function f of x equal to x cube minus 3x square plus 3x minus 100 is increasing in R. Means this is throughout increasing function. Throughout increasing function. Okay. Now, to prove this, what is the given function f of x is equal to x cube minus 3x square plus 3x minus 100. Now, differentiate with respect to x on both sides, what we get? F of x derivative f dash of x is equal to x cube derivative. X cube derivative is 3x square minus 3 into x square derivative 2x, no? So, minus 3 into 2x, nothing but minus 6x plus 3x derivative is 3. So, f dash of x is equal to 3x square minus 6x plus 3. So, overall 3 common, So, what we get? 3 into x square minus 2x plus 1. 3 into x square minus 2x plus 1. Now, x square minus 2x plus 1, what we can write? X minus 1 whole square, no? So, f dash of x is equal to what we got? 3 into x minus 1 whole square. Now, if you consider any real number, x minus 1 whole square is always greater than or equal to 0. X minus 1 whole square is always greater than or equal to 0. Now, when x is equal to 1, 0, remaining for all real numbers, x minus 1 whole square is always greater than 0. So, overall, for any real number, x minus 1 whole square is always greater than or equal to 0. Now, x minus 1 whole square is greater than or equal to 0 means 3 into x minus 1 whole square is always greater than or equal to 0. 3 into x minus 1 whole square is always greater than or equal to 0 means f dash of x is greater than or equal to 0. f dash of x is greater than or equal to 0. Okay, f dash of x is greater than or equal to 0 for every real number. Okay, as f dash of x is greater than or equal to 0 for every real number, f is increasing function for every real number. Means f is increasing function in R. Okay. given function is f of x equal to x cube minus 3x square plus 3x minus 100. Okay, f dash of x is what we got, 3 into x minus 1 whole square. For any real number, x minus 1 whole square is greater than or equal to 0. 3 into x minus 1 whole square is greater than or equal to 0. Means f dash of x is greater than or equal to 0. For every real number. For any real number, f dash of x is greater than or equal to 0. So f is increasing function in R. F is increasing function in R. Okay. Next, last question in this exercise. Last question in this exercise. The interval in which y is equal to x square into e power minus x is increasing with respect to x. The interval in which y is equal to x square minus e power minus x is increasing with respect to x. Here options are minus infinity to plus infinity, minus 2 to 0, 2 to infinity, 0 to 2. Okay. Now, first of all, what is given function? Given function is y is equal to x square into e power minus x. X square into e power minus x. Now, differentiate with respect to x. What we get? Dy by dx is equal to. Now, here product rule. First function into derivative of second function plus second function into derivative of first function. So, dy by dx equal to x square into e power minus x derivative, e power minus x into minus 1. E power minus x derivative, e power minus x derivative minus 1. Plus e power minus x as it is, e power minus x as it is, x square derivative is 2x. So dy by dx equal to what? X square into e power minus x into minus 1 plus 2x into e power minus x. Okay? Now, from these two terms, we can take x common as well as e power minus x common. So x into e power minus x common. X into e power minus x common, x into e power minus x common. So still we have x and multiplied by minus sign. So minus x and x e power minus x common means plus 2. So minus x plus 2. X into e power minus x into minus x plus 2. Nothing but x into 2 minus x into e power minus x. X into 2 minus x into e power minus x. Okay. Now, but this is f dash of x, wherever f dash of x is positive, in that interval f of x is increasing function, wherever f dash of x is negative, the function f of x is decreasing function. Now here e power x or e power minus x is always positive. So e power minus x is always positive. For every real number e power minus x is positive. So f dash of x or dy by dx is positive or negative depends on x into 2 minus x. So if you equate to 0, this part what you get, x equal to 0, x is equal to 2. So x is equal to 0 and x is equal to 2. If you mark 0 and 2 on number line, real number line, so it will be like this. Okay. So divides the entire number line in three parts, minus infinity to 0, 0 to 2 and 2 to infinity. Okay. Now in each interval, we'll verify sine of f dash of x or sine of dy by dx and nature of f of x or nature of y. Okay. So in the interval minus infinity to 0, minus infinity to 0, any number you choose, easy number, minus 1. Okay. So for minus 1, when x is equal to minus 1, minus 1 into 2 minus of minus plus 1. So this is positive, negative, positive. So negative, positive, negative product is negative. So f dash of x is negative. So f dash of x is negative means in this interval f of x is decreasing function. F of x is decreasing function. F of x is decreasing function. Okay. Next. In the interval 0 to 2, in between 0 to 2, easy number is 1. Okay. At x is equal to 1, we'll verify. So f dash of x is equal to what? X into 2 minus x into e power minus x. Now f dash of 1. So 1 into 2 minus 1. Positive, positive, e power minus 1 is always positive anyhow, e power minus x is positive. So positive into positive is positive. So 0 to 2, f dash of x is positive. So as f dash of x is positive, f is increasing function. F is increasing function in 0 to 2. Okay. Now what about 2 to infinity? Now 2 to infinity, okay, in the interval 2 to infinity, choose any easy number 3. Okay, at x is equal to 3. So 3 into, in place of x if you write 3, 3 into 2 minus 3, 2 minus 3 minus 1 negative, so positive, negative, positive, overall product is negative. So 2 to infinity f dash of x is negative. Now in 2 to infinity f dash of x is negative means f of x is a decreasing function in the interval 2 to infinity. So in which interval f of x is positive? F of x is increasing. F of x is increasing in the interval 0 to 2. F of x is increasing in the interval 0 to 2. Nothing but fourth option is correct answer. Fourth option is correct answer. Okay. Here once again I'll repeat. Here given function f of x equal to x square into e power minus x. Now differentiate with respect to x on both sides. F dash of x or dy by dx is equal to product rule. First function into derivative of second function plus second function into derivative of first function. Okay, x into e power minus x common. So x into e power minus x into minus x plus 2. So what we can write x into 2 minus x into e power minus x. Okay, e power minus x is always positive. So f dash of x positive or negative depend on x into 2 minus x. So zeros of f dash of x is x equal to 0 and x is equal to 2. So mark 0 and 2 on number line. Okay, now verify the sign of f dash of x in the interval minus infinity to 0 and 0 to 2 and 2 to infinity. Okay, minus infinity to 0, okay, f dash of x is negative, so f is a decreasing function in this interval. Okay, in between 0 to 2, f dash of x is positive, so f is increasing function in this interval. Okay, 2 to infinity, f dash of x is negative, f is decreasing function in this interval. So f of x is increasing in the interval 0 to 2. Okay, fourth option is correct answer. Okay, now with this we completed this exercise. Okay, next class we will start tangents and normals. Okay, ma, thank you.